I've taken a lot of photos in GT Sport, and today I'll be looking at my gallery and giving you some of my favorite tips to make use of the photo mode and scapes. Stick around till the end for an amazing hack. First up, just make sure you're positioning your subject properly. Don't put it right in the middle of the image, that doesn't look great. Instead, what you can do is utilize something called the law of thirds, which involves mentally dividing up your image using two horizontal lines and two vertical lines. What you then do is you position the important elements in your scene either along those lines or on the intersections. This is, of course, just a general rule, you don't have to use it, and I'll leave a link in the description if you want to know more. Next, just make sure you have some interesting angles in your shot. So here's a quick tip: lower shots, especially low front quarter ones, they look really fast and they emphasize your car a lot more. So if you're focusing on the car, go for a lower shot. However, if you want to focus on the environment more, then you can either go for something like a side view or an elevated view, like a top view. This can create a better balance between the environment and the car. Also, you might want to try with multiple cars, but if you position them with the rule of thirds, it'll look really good. So that's another thing you can try out. What you can also do is, if you're taking photos of a stationary car, just add a little bit of steering angle. That adds a bit of depth and interest to the tires. You also need to decide whether you're taking a still shot or a moving shot. And again, you need to think whether your location is realistic or not. Think about it. A car wouldn't be still on a road and moving on a garden, right? So again, when you're taking a still shot, you need a showcase type angle. So go for like higher views, top views, high front quarters, etc. And which can also show the environment. But if you're taking a moving shot especially, low front quarters, they look really nice. They showcase the speed of your car so much, and they're some of my favorite shots. What you can also do is try and have an interesting relationship between the car and the environment. For example, a modern futuristic Vision Gran Turismo or something in modern surroundings, an old car in a rustic place, or even vice versa. You could try putting a McLaren VGT next to a British cottage. That looks cool. Or you can do something like a British car in a British place. So the nationality also matters, so you can experiment with that. Again, think about color a lot. Contrasting and matching colors between the car and the background look great. So on a white background, if you have an orange car, that's going to look great. Another thing is, most cars look better on a white background than a black one. So if you want to just show off your car, no distractions, don't go for a black background, just a white one. Again, think about the time of day also, because shooting at evening, it's going to be a lot warmer, but if you're shooting in the morning, it's going to be a bit cooler. So you need to think about what kind of effect you're trying to give with your image. You might also want to get rid of contrast altogether. A black car at night with the headlights on will look really cool. And a white car on snow could also lead to some interesting shots. You can also photograph the background as the same color as your car. All you have to do is just find the RGB values of the main color of your car, and then just go to the brightness settings and set it to like that. And that can create some nice shapes between the car and the background. Next up is my favorite tip. Go for funny or interesting shots. Especially with the driver, what you can do is compose your scene in a way which is visually interesting and do something unique. So I did this one where I have a driver face palming because there's a Corvette in a desert and it stopped. You can obviously guess what happened there, right? And you can just do gags like this. I saw this Amazon background and I thought, how would an Amazon livery look with this? So I took a Clio, put an Amazon livery on it, and I took a photo. So go for some gags also, that might be nice. And since the driver can represent emotions, you can take a driver pose, say for example a victory pose, and then build a shot around that. So for example, how did he win? What did he win? Who did he win against? So you can create a shot with this stuff in mind. And you can basically tell an indirect story through your picture. You can also try and put yourself in the shoes of the real life photographer who might have been there. Why was this photo taken? What happened here? What is the significance? Also think about the lighting in the background, like I mentioned before, with the time of day. You can also use a technique called bokeh. So all you have to do is decrease the aperture to minimum or just above minimum, use a lock-on autofocus, and then focus on your car. If you want to know more about bokeh, again, I'll leave another link in the description. Another guaranteed way to get good photos is to experiment with the settings. You might not know what all of these do. I'll leave some resources in the description. But what you can just do is turn the dials from minimum to maximum. Just see what happens. You might find something interesting, just maybe decrease the saturation completely, or maybe just turn up the contrast all the way to maximum. Just experiment and see what happens. You might like it. So the next step is to focus on the details. Is there any particular detail on your car that you really like? Maybe the tail lights or the headlights are in a really unique shape. You can zoom all the way in and maybe even focus on some obscure details that people don't usually see. Now on to panning shots. If you're having problems with car placement, then keep it in the middle of the placeable area, otherwise you'll get an error. However, this can lead to some interesting effects, so you can even try that out. If you have two cars and you'd like to focus on both, decrease the speed of the second car and increase the speed of the first one. There's also an interesting glitch in Scapes. It normally doesn't let you place multiple copies of the same car. However, if you shoot the photo, go to My Library, press the Options button on the photo, and then click Open in Scapes, you can actually place the same car again. If you're really having trouble with taking photos though, here's a really simple hack that you can do. I used a random number generator for this one. I got 196 for the car, which is a Renault Megane. I got 3 for the location, which was the Eiffel region. And then I again got 12 for the Scape number. After that, here's what I did. First of all, I put a bit of steering angle and I made sure that my car was in the lower left third. Decreased the aperture all the way down and I used the lock-on autofocus function to focus on the car. And then I went into filters, I went into screen effect 1, applied a background mask and then put a bleach bypass on the background. I then went into car driver effects and applied a lo-fi filter. These last two are what really make the trick. So this is a really simple trick that you can do if you want to make any photo you take look good. This has been Afraid Racer, and thanks for watching.